Hello all, welcome back to my channel. Today we deal with the very important theorem, Leibniz theorem, or it is also called as the product rule for nth derivative. So this theorem is used to find the nth derivative of the product form. Okay. So first let us see what is the statement. Let u and v be two functions, then nth derivative of u and v is equals to u as it is nth derivative of v, so that is it is denoted by vn, plus, or you may denote it by dn of v also, plus nc 1 differentiation of this u is denoted by u1, and vn minus 1. So here vn minus 1 is, so in the nth derivative of v, we replace n by n minus 1. Next, plus nc 2 u2, u2 means differentiation of u, okay, this u1, so that is nth second order differentiation of u into vn minus 2, plus nc 3 u3 vn minus 3 and so on. Lastly, we get nth derivative of u1 and v as it is. Okay, so this is the product rule of nth order derivative of two functions. Okay, or it is the Leibniz theorem. So here we know that nc1 can be written as n, because nc1 always n, and nc2 is equals to n into n minus 1 divided by 2 factorial, nc3 equals to n into n minus 1, n minus 2 divided by 3 factorial, and so on. On substituting these values, we get nth derivative of uv is equals to u as it is vn plus nc1 value is n, u1 vn minus 1 plus n into n minus 1 divided by 2 factorial, u2 vn minus 2 plus and so on, we get un into v. Okay, so here these subscripts u1, u2, u3 and vn, vn minus 1, these all denotes the successive differentiation. Okay, so derivative of the this u and v. So you must remember this formula. And here choosing first function or second function is very important. We always choose second function whose nth derivative is known. Okay, so that means always choose second function as v whose nth derivative is known. Okay, and we choose algebraic polynomials like x, ax plus b, ax plus b raised to n, or x square and so on. So all these terms we choose as a first function, because after some steps it becomes zero, because when m is less than n, we get nth derivative equals to zero. So therefore, after some steps, derivative of this function becomes zero, then this rule terminates, that is this rule terminates, therefore we use these algebraic functions x, x plus b, x plus b raised to n, so not n, so square, and so on as a first function. Okay, so we will well understood by you by solving some examples. So remember this product rule, we keep first function as it is, nth derivative of second function, so the plus we put a constant nc1 into first derivative of the first function, derivative of the first function, and vn minus 1. So here n minus vn minus 1 means in the nth derivative we replace n by n minus 1. Same again, we put a constant nc2, differentiation of this u1. Okay, so that means second order derivative of this u2 means second order derivative. Okay, so like this we simplify this one. So if it terminates, that means if u is of the algebraic or polynomial function, this rule terminates, otherwise it goes on the nth derivative of un. We should write the nth derivative of this u and we get into v, because after some steps we get vn minus 3, vn minus, lastly we get vn minus n, means which is equals to v naught, means v itself. Okay, so like this. The Leibniz theorem can also be written as dn of u into v is equals to u as it is, nth derivative of v plus constant nc1, or we can directly write n u1 means differentiation of u, and dn minus 1 of v plus n into n minus 1 divided by 2 factorial d square of u into dn minus 2 of v, and so on. Lastly, we get nth derivative of u into v. We can write in this form also. Okay, so which one is you remember that form? So remembering this formula is very, very important. Now we should solve some problems. First one, find the nth derivative of the followings. In that, first one is x cube into e raised to x. So here x cube is an algebraic function. Also we know that nth derivative of e raised to ax. Therefore we choose this function as the first function and e raised to x as a second function. Okay. Solution. Let u equals to x cube and v equals to e raised to ax. So because some steps the derivative of this x cube becomes 0. Okay. So because u1 equals to, we get 3x square, u2 equals to 6x, and u3 equals to 6, then u4 will be 0. Okay. So and we know that nth derivative of this vn is equals to a raised to n e raised to ax. So nth derivative of this un will be 0, because here this 3 is less than n. So therefore, now applying formula Leibniz rule, we get nth derivative of uv. First we write the formula, u as it is, nth derivative of n plus nc1 u1, that is derivative of this u, vn minus 1, plus nc2 u2 vn minus 2, and so on. Or you can directly substitute this constant values also. Okay, in the next problem we consider like that only. Okay, so next un, so here we get simply v. Okay, therefore nth derivative of given function x cube e raised to ax is equals to x cube as it is, nth derivative of e raised to ax, which is equals to a raised to n into e raised to ax, plus nc1 value equals to n. We substitute that value in next step. Next u1, that is differentiation of this x cube. So differentiation of x cube is 3x square into vn minus 1. So in the so this we should observe the first function first, that is nth derivative of this one. We simply replace n by n minus 1. So here we have a raised to n, therefore we keep it as a raised to n minus 1 e raised to ax as it is. Next, nc2, 3x square differentiation is 6x, and replacing n by n, so in this replacing n by n minus 2, we get n minus 2 e raised to ax as it is, plus nc3, 6x differentiation is 6, and replacing this n by n minus 3, we get a raised to n minus 3 e raised to ax as it is. So next step will be 0, because differentiation of this 6 is equals to, we get 0. So for this particular problem, this rule terminates here itself. Okay. So in all these, we can take e raised to ax common, e raised to ax common, we get x cube into a raised to n, plus we substitute nc1 value which is equals to n, so that we get, first we write this 3nx square an minus 1, plus substituting nc2 value we get 6 as it is, n into n minus 1 divided by 2 into this x into a raised to n minus 2 as it is, plus here nc3 value is 6, first we write 6, n into n minus 1 n minus 2 into n minus 3 divided by 6, 3 factorial value is equals to 6 into a raised to n minus 3 as it is. So now this 6 6 get answers 2 1s are 2 3s are. So simplifying, that is further simplifying, we get e raised to x equals to x cube a raised to n plus 3n x square a raised to n minus 1 plus 3n into n minus 1 into x into a raised to n minus 2 plus n into n minus 1 n minus 2 n minus 3 into a raised to n minus 3. So this is the required nth derivative of the given function. Next, second problem, e raised to x into log x. Solution, here both the nth derivative is known, we can choose anyone as the first function and anyone as the second function. But if we choose e raised to x as the second function whose nth derivative is, that is the n of e raised to x is e raised to x itself, so then we no need to change them n. Okay, that means we can here there is not necessary to replace the n value because it doesn't contains n values. So therefore it is better to choose e raised to x as the second function. Okay, so thus let u equals to log x and v equals to e raised to x. So here this doesn't vanishes because after some steps it get the nth derivative. So that is un of this nth derivative of log x. We know that nth derivative of log x is minus 1 raised to n minus 1 factorial divided by x raised to n. Okay, and vn of this one, that is nth derivative of e raised to x, is e raised to x itself. So here remember that vn indicates that nth derivative of this one. Okay, so here un means nth derivative of u, and vn means nth derivative of v. Okay, now applying the Leibniz theorem. Applying Leibniz theorem, we get nth derivative of u into v is given by u as it is, nth derivative of vn plus nc1 value, here we directly substitute n into u1 पी एन माइनस वन प्लस एन इंटू एन माइनस वन डिवाइड बाय टू फैक्टोरियल यू टू वी एन माइनस टू प्लस एंड सो ऑन वी गेट यू इंटू सो सॉरी यू एन इंटू पी. सो देयरफॉर हियर लॉग एक्स एज इट इज vn means nth derivative of e raised to x is e raised to x itself plus n into log x differentiation is 1 by x into again it is e raised to x itself because there is no n terms here plus n into n minus 1 divided by 2 factorial 1 by x differentiation is minus 1 by x square then e raised to x as it is and so on we get un means log x differentiation nth derivative of log x is minus 1 raised to n n minus 1 factorial divided by x raised to n again e raised to x as it is. So in all these terms we can take e raised to x common. So on taking e raised to x common we get log x plus n in by x minus here n into n minus 1 divided by 2 factorial is 2 into x square and so on. So last term will be minus 1 raised to n n minus 1 factorial divided by x raised to n. So this is the required answer. Okay, next third problem. If y equals to log x divided by x, then prove that yn equals to minus 1 raised to n n factorial divided by x raised to n plus 1 into log x minus 1 minus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3 and so on minus 1 by n. So here given function is log x by x. So this can be written as solution. So here given function is y equals to log x into we can write it as into 1 by x. Let u equals to log x and v equals to 1 by x. So we know that nth derivative of this un is equals to that is log x nth derivative is minus 1 raised to n minus 1 into n minus 1 factorial divided by x raised to n and nth derivative of this 1 by x is minus 1 raised to n n factorial divided by x raised to n plus 1. Okay, so now applying the Leibniz theorem, we get, so that is we have nth derivative of uv is equals to u as it is nth derivative of vn plus one constant n nc1 value is n u1 vn minus 1 plus n into n minus 1 divided by 2 factorial u2 vn minus 2 and so on. Lastly we get un into v. This is the formula. Now substituting the values we get u means this log x as it is nth derivative of vn is minus 1 raised to n n factorial divided by x raised to n plus 1 plus constant n as it is u1 is log x differentiation is 1 by x vn minus 1 vn minus 1 means replacing this n by n minus 1 we get n minus 1 factorial divided by here denominator we get replacing n by n minus 1 we get simply get plus 1 minus 1 get cancels we get xn plus next term will be n into n minus 1 divided by 2 factorial is 2 and you can write 2 factorial also. This 1 by x differentiation is minus 1 by x square and replacing n by n minus 2 we get minus 1 raised to n minus 2 factorial divided by x raised to n minus 2. sorry, not n minus 2. Replacing this n by n minus 2, we get plus 1 minus 2 is equals to n minus 1. This is n minus 1. And so on. The last term will be minus 1 raised to n minus 2. That is nth derivative of log x. Sorry, this is not n minus 2. It is n minus 1 into n minus 1 factorial divided by x raised to n into v as it is. V as it is means 1 by x as it is. Okay. Now, further simplifying this one, we get, so here un means it is yn. Yn equals to this log x as it is. So now, we can take minus 1 raised to n common from all these terms. Okay, so see here, if I take minus 1 raised to n common, in the bracket we will get log x into n factorial divided by x raised to n plus 1, right? Plus here minus 1 raised to n I have taken common, so it becomes minus 1 raised to n minus 1. We will see what value, so value of this minus 1 raised to minus 1 later on, into n minus 1 factorial. And denominator here we have one term of x, so adding powers we get x raised to n plus 1 plus. So on taking minus 1 raised to n outside, we get my so this is plus, here we have minus sign, plus into minus, we get minus, minus 1 raised to, already we have taken raised to n outside, so we get minus 2. So then here we have n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 factorial. So this is n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 factorial, and denominator we get this 2 factorial is 2, and x power, adding x power 2 is there, 2 plus n minus 1, we get x raised to 2 minus 1 is equals to, we get x raised to n plus 1 plus, and so on. Last term minus 1 raised to, we get here minus 1 n minus 1 factorial divided by x raised to n into, sorry, 1 by x, so we take this x raised to this side, so x power we get plus 1. So here you can observe that this is n factorial. Here n into n minus 1 we have n factorial, n into n minus 1 n minus 2 is also n factorial. So like this, in the all terms we get n factorial common, and even in the last term here we have simply n minus 1. If I divide and multiply this term by n by n, we get n into n minus 1 as a n factorial. So therefore we know that since n into n minus 1 factorial is n factorial, we can take n factorial common from all these terms, but in the last term, so we need one more n term, therefore we divide and multiply this by n. Okay, and even in the denominator we have all x power n plus 1, therefore we can take, so this can be simplified as yn equals to minus 1 raised to n, denominator we can take x raised to n plus 1, okay, common we get log x into n factorial plus this minus 1 raised to n is equals to, so since here minus 1 raised to minus 1 can be written as 1 divided by minus 1, which is equals to minus 1 only. So power 1 means it is minus 1 only. So similarly, minus 1 raised to minus 2, if the power is even, don't bother about the sign, if power is even, we get plus sign. So therefore, so here we get plus into minus, minus sign. So its value is equals to minus. So n into n minus 1 is n factorial. Denominator we have taken x raised to n plus 1 outside. So next, minus, its power is even, therefore we get plus sign. N into n minus 1 n minus 2 is n factorial, and next term will be same, minus we get. So next, lastly, so here we have minus 1 power minus 1 is minus itself, n minus 1 factorial. So this n into n minus 1 factorial is n factorial, denominator we get n. this term taken outside. So n factorial divided by n. So in the all terms we can take n factorial also common. So taking n factorial common, we get minus 1 raised to n, n factorial divided by x raised to n plus 1. So this becomes log x minus 1. So sorry, in the denominator we have 2 here, n factorial divided by 2. So n factorial divided by 2. So therefore it is minus 1 by 2. And so on we get, last term will be n factorial taken outside, we get 1 by n. So this is the required proof. Okay. Next, fourth problem. If y equals to x raised to n log x, then show that yn plus 1 equals to n factorial divided by x. This is quite different problem. So here we have n plus 1 means. So this n plus 1 means if I apply y to nth derivative, it becomes yn. If I apply yn nth derivative, we get yn plus 1. So if I apply nth derivative for y to, we get yn plus 2. So remember this term. So the question is given that yn plus 1 means we have to apply the nth derivative for this y1. Y1 means it is nothing but first order derivative of y. Okay. So that means in this case, first we have to find the first order derivative, then we apply the nth derivative, then we get the yn plus 1 value. So that, so here given function is y equals to x raised to n log x, applying UV formula, not the Leibniz, simple UV formula, we get y1 x raised to n as it is log x differentiation 1 by x. In the next step, log x as it is 1 by x difference, this x raised to n differentiation n into x raised to n minus 1. Further simplifying, we take x LCM. So on taking x LCM, we get x raised to n. So this is not equals to, this is plus. Here we get n as it is. So we should multiply this term by x. So multiplying with x, and this x raised to n minus 1 as it is into log x as it is. So here we have 5. Now, so we take this x to the this side, we get x into y1 equals to, this becomes x raised to n plus n into, so x power becomes plus 1 minus 1 get cancels, x raised to n log x. So this is nothing but the given function y. Thus we substitute x into y1 x raised to n, this n into y, this term is equals to 1, because given that y equals to x raised to n log x. So substituting this value, we get this step. Now we apply the Leibniz theorem for this term. That is, now applying Leibniz theorem. Okay, so Leibniz theorem, where we apply only in the product form. So here we have product form, so therefore only RHS side we apply the Leibniz theorem. So here we can directly get the x raised to n, nth derivative of this x raised to n, and even here n is constant, we simply get x nth derivative of this y. So that means in the only RHS part only we have product form, therefore we apply this Leibniz theorem. So that is nth derivative of x into y1 is equals to, we get nth derivative of x raised to n plus n becomes constant, nth derivative of this y. Now applying Leibniz theorem only RHS side, so we get, so we take x as a first function, y1 as a second function. So x as it is, so here let for this one only x u equals to x and v equals to y1. Okay, so let x equals to u equals to x and v equals to y1. So nth derivative of x we get 0, and nth derivative of vn is equals to n plus 1. 1 plus n, or it is n plus 1. Therefore, so this becomes nth derivative of x into y1 becomes first u as it is, nth derivative of y1 is n plus 1 plus 1 constant, x differentiation is 1. Next yn plus 1 differentiation, replacing n by n minus 1 we get. So on replacing n by n minus 1, plus 1 minus 1 get cancels, we get simply n plus next n into n minus 1, but differentiation of this 1 will be 0. So in the next step we get 0, only we get 2 terms. So got this one. So we apply Leibniz theorem only RHS side. So here RHS side we let u equals to x and v equals to y1, and the derivative of this vn will be yn plus 1. Okay, now x as it is, u as it is, nth derivative of vn, so that is un plus 1. Here we are, I am not writing the formula here. Next n, some constant, that is n into x differentiation 1, yn plus 1, replacing n by n minus 1 we get yn plus, next term will be 0 because differentiation of this 1 is 0, so it terminates here itself. Next see the RHS side, x raised to n, nth derivative of x raised to n, so we should write the nth derivative of x raised to n. We know that nth derivative of x raised to n is equals to n factorial, because here m and n both are same. So in the note I have written the nth derivative of x raised to n is n factorial, therefore it is n factorial plus n, nth derivative of y is yn. So you remember this formula. So simplifying this we get x into yn plus 1 plus n into yn equals to n into yn plus n factorial. This yn into yn get cancels, we simply get x into yn plus 1 equals to n factorial, or yn plus 1 equals to n factorial divided by x. So this is the required proof. So these kind of problems are very very important for your exams. In the exams they ask like this only, okay, so which includes yn plus 1, yn plus 2. There you should first find the y1, y2, then we apply the Leibniz theorem if required, not all the terms. So here only for this term we require Leibniz theorem, therefore we are applying only for this term. So like that, wherever required we apply the Leibniz theorem for those terms, okay. So so that type of problems we will see in the next video. So thanks for watching.